Hey everybody, nice to see you again. Welcome back to another video. And I'm really excited for the topic. Today it's going to be multi-plane cameras in Toonboom. Right, so a multi-plane camera just adds a lot of depth to your scene. It's that whole concept where elements in the foreground move quicker than elements in the background. When you pan or zoom, it doesn't look like just a flat image. It looks like your scene has depth and it looks way better. So here's the scene that we're going to be working on. As you can see, we have our foreground, our midground, our mountains in the back, and our background. And all these views show the same thing, just in different ways. So we have a perspective view that kind of shows us that all these images are on one flat plane, so there's no layering at all. This top view kind of just gives us a different angle of the camera. So here's the camera right here, and everything in this field of view is what the camera sees. And this line, this is where our elements are in relation to that camera. So if you can see, they're all on the same black line. When we try and add a pan, so if we play this and look up here, we see it's just very, very boring. It just looks like we're zooming in on a flat image. So how do we fix that? What we can do is add a multiplane camera. So I like to do it in the top view, and we're going to reorder these elements. So let's select the foreground first, and let's zoom in so we can see what we're doing, and click and drag it forward. All right, see how it's coming forward? Let's drag it more. Uh-oh. The problem is, though, as it comes closer to the camera, it gets bigger and bigger, and we don't really want that. Usually when you have a background, it's already composited nice. We don't want to change that. So all we need to do is go up to our advanced animation tab and click this button here, maintain size. So now, and then even an arrow pops up. So now when we move this forward, it doesn't change here, but you can see in our perspective view, it is coming forward. So let's bring it real close like that. Usually our mid-ground elements, like where the characters are going to be, we're not going to touch that. We're going to keep that where it is. Next, we're going to take our mountains and we're going to move them back. See how they disappeared? That's just because now they're layered behind the sky. So let's take the sky and move that all the way back as well. We could probably do it a little bit more. Mountains, a little bit more like this. So it's very easy. You can see the difference in size, but you can also see because we have our maintain size tool, everything stays the same. So now what happens when we play this? And already you can feel the difference when you play it. There's a lot of depth added to this scene. So all you need is your top view where you can reorder your elements. You can have your perspective view just to see what it looks like in perspective, but you don't really need this. This was just an example to show you guys. And make sure your maintain size is on. So that's it, guys. No joke, that's how easy it is to add some depth to your scenes in Toonboom. What I used to do is I actually used to resize each element and tween it that way. And it was just a nightmare to make changes. It was a nightmare to modify. So here with the multiplane camera, and your top view to reorder things in Z depth, it just gives you so much more control and it's way, way faster to make changes to. Honestly, get used to looking at the top view to see the Z depth order of each element in your scene. It doesn't just have to be for background elements, it can also be for parts of a character rig or just hand-drawn character layers. It's really, really helpful to see the actual Z depth layering. You can find this file that I used on Toonboom's website. I'll link to that module so you guys can practice using the multiplane camera as well. And check out the rest of their courses. They have a whole bunch of free resources for animators using Toonboom. A quick video today, guys. That's all the time we have though. It's pretty late here. I'm gonna sign off for the day, but I will see you guys in the next video. Happy animating.